Hello viewers, welcome back to UN College Digital Classes. Today I am going to discuss on regarding the tax period. The person derives income will pay the tax. In which period the person derives income, in which period the person liable to pay the tax. So this period is to be assessment year and previous year. As per the income tax law, the person derives income in the previous year liable to pay the tax in the assessment year. So here is the first one, is assessment year is the financial year of the government. This period is totaling of 12 months starting from 1st April end with the 31st March of the next year. So here is the current assessment year is 2020 and 2021. This period is starting from 1st April 2020 and end with 31st March 2021. Within this period, the person derives income in the previous year liable to pay the tax within this period in the assessment year. So here is the previous year. The previous year is the preceding the assessment year or the financial year, just immediate preceding the assessment year or the financial year. So this period is totaling of the 12 months starting from 1st April end with 31st March of the next year. So here is current previous year is 2019 and 2020. This period will be starting from 1st April 2019 and end with 31st March of 2020. Within this period, assessee derives income, person derives income, the total income of the person liable to pay the tax within this period, that is assessment year. So, as per the law, person's total income derives in the previous year make payment tax, liable to pay the tax in the assessment year. So there is some exceptional cases of the income tax law. As per the income tax law, in the total income of the previous year of person will pay the tax in the next year of the assessment year. Here is the exceptional cases, the person derives income liable to pay the tax in the same year. The year in which the person derives income, in the same year person pay the tax. So these are the exceptional cases. First one is shipping business of non-resident ship owners. If the non-resident ship owners carrying on shipping business in the Indian ports by carrying on the passenger, livestock, mails, goods, but the ship owners has no representative in India, so liable to pay the tax in the same year in which the shipping business derives income. Second case, in case person living India, intention of the person derives income during the previous year, during the current year, but the intention leave India, not to return in the assessment year. Suppose the person derives income during the previous year 2019 and 20 and leave the India in 2019 and 20 with the intention not to return in the assessment year 2020 and 21. In such a case, the person derives income in the previous year 2019 and 20 bound to pay the tax in the 2019 and 20, not waiting for the assessment year 2020 and 21. Third case, any association of persons, body of individual, artificial, juridical person established for the limited period or for the event completion. So, after the limited period is to be completed, event is to be completed. In the same period, the association of person, body of individual, artificial, juridical person liable to pay the tax in the same period. Fourth one is, in case person who are likely transfer assets to avoid the tax. That means if the income tax officer fails, the person likely transfer the assets to any other person only for the purpose of avoid the tax. In such a case, the year in which the person transfer the asset, sell the asset, dispose of the asset in the same year, liable to pay the tax. So these are the exceptional cases of the income tax or rule. General rule is to be the income deriving by assets in the previous year, pay the tax in the assessment year. But in the exceptional cases, the income deriving by assets in the year, liable to pay the tax, liable to pay the tax in the same year. So these are the exceptional cases. So here is assessment year and previous year. So okay, now I am going to discussion regarding the assessee under section 2 clause 7 of the Income Tax Act 1961. Assessee may be a person by whom any tax or any other sum of money is payable under this act. So here is under this act means Income Tax Act 1961. Whether the person is payable any tax or any other sum of money as per this act, that may be interest, that may be penalty, that may be points, whatever may be amount is to be paid or payable by the person as per the Act of Income Tax 1961, so that person is to be known as assessee. So here is assessee may be of ordinary assessee, may be of a representative assessee, may be of assessee in default. So here is ordinary assessee. The assessee, the person against whom some proceedings are going on under this act, that means as per the Income Tax Act 1961, simply proceedings are going on as per the law, whether the any amount of tax, interest, penalty paid, payable or not, that is immaterial. Simply proceedings are going on, so that person is to be termed as ordinary assessee. Second one is the person who sustained the loss during the previous year and file return of loss in the assessment year, so that person is to be known as ordinary assessee. Carrying on the business, carrying on the profession, finding out the total income, the person sustained the loss during the previous year and file return of loss to the income tax department as per the law during the assessment year, so that person is to be treated as ordinary assessee. Third category is the person by whom some amount of interest, tax, penalty is payable under this act. The person by whom some amount of interest, that may be charged by the income tax department as per the law, tax is to be charged by the income tax department as per the law, penalty is to be charged by the income tax department as per the law, it's payable by the person, so that person is to be known as ordinary assessee. Second category of assessee is representative assessee. So here is the representative assessee means the person not only liable for his own income or own loss, but also liable for the income and the loss of any other person. So that person is to be known as a representative assessee. That means the guardian of a lunatic person, minor, idiot person, agent of NRI. So these are the representative assessee. Third category is assessee in default. So here is assessee in default. That means the person who fails to meet the statutory obligation as per the law of the income tax law. The person who fails to meet the statutory obligation, so that person is to be known as assessee in default. Take an example. Suppose there is employer-employee relationship. Employee give authorization to the employer for deduction some amount of his monthly income and deposited in the government treasury as advance tax or TDS. Advance tax or TDS. Employer deducted the amount but not deposited in the government treasury, or employer fails to deduct the amount from the salary of the employee. In such a case, employer is to be treated as assessee in default. Employer fails to meet the statutory obligation. So, employer will be treated as assessee in default. So, these are the assessee, ordinary assessee, representative assessee and assessee in default. The total income of assessee is determined, total income of person is determined as per the income tax law on the basis of a residential status of assessee. The residential status of assessee is to be determined on the basis of number of days stayed by the assessee in India during the previous year. So, accordingly the total income is to be determined. The residential status of assessee as per the law under section 6 clause 1, that may be resident, that may be non-resident. That means Indian citizen may be treated as non-resident, but the foreign citizen may be treated as a resident. So, this residential status is to be determined on the basis of number of days stayed in India. So, if the assessee will be treated as a resident, he should fulfill any one condition under section 6 clause 1. He should fulfill any one condition out of these two under section 6 clause 1. So, first condition, the person or the assessee must stay in India for a period of 182 days or more during the relevant current previous year. Suppose the relevant current previous year is 2019 and 2020. In 2019 and 2020, the assessee must stay in India for a period of 182 days. The period is to be starting from 1st April end with the 31st March. Within this period, total assessee must stay in India for a period of 182 days minimum. So, his residential status is to be treated as a resident. Second condition, if the assessee not stay in India for a period of 182 days in the current previous year, apply the second condition, the person must stay in India for a period of 365 days or more during 4 previous year preceding the relevant previous year. Relevant previous year means current previous year, the previous year in which the residential status of assessee is to be determined. The preceding of that current previous year, 4 preceding previous year, in which total 365 days or more assessee must stay in India, and assessee must stay in India for a period of 60 days or more during the relevant current previous year, then his residential status is to be treated as a resident. Any one condition must be fulfilled by assessee. If the first condition is not fulfilled, apply the second condition. If the second condition is fulfilled, then assessee is to be treated as a resident. If both the condition is not fulfilled by assessee, neither assessee stay in India for a period of 182 days or more during the relevant current previous year, nor the assessee stay in India for a period of 365 days or more during 4 previous year preceding the relevant previous year and 60 days or more during the relevant previous year, both the conditions, any one condition is not fulfilled by the assessee. So, his residential status is to be treated as non-resident. So, one is resident, second one is non-resident. After determination the residential status of assessee is resident, again assessee may claim the beneficial residential status, that may be ordinary resident and not ordinary a resident. Assessee claim that I am resident but ordinary a resident. I am resident but not ordinary a resident. To become ordinary resident, both the condition must fulfill by assessee, both the condition, along with any one condition under section 6(1). First you have to prove the assessee is resident, again assessee is claim I am resident but ordinary a resident. To become the ordinary resident, both the condition must fulfill by assessee. So, what are these conditions? first condition is the person or the assessee is a resident in India in two previous year out of 10 previous year preceding the relevant previous year, the current previous year preceding 10 previous year in which at least two previous year the residential status of person is a resident. That means the assessee must show is resident by fulfilling any one condition under section 6(1). Person is resident in India in two previous year out of 10 previous year preceding the relevant current previous year. Second condition, the person must stay in India for a period of 730 days or more in 7 previous year preceding the relevant current previous year, just immediate preceding the relevant current previous year in 7 previous year in totaling, assessee must stay in India for a period of 730 days or more, he will be treated as resident but ordinary resident. To become the ordinary resident, both the condition must fulfill by assessee. So, resident, again he claim the ordinary resident. So, assessee may claim the beneficial residential status as ordinary resident or not ordinary resident. To become the ordinary resident, assessee must fulfill both the condition. So, here is to become the not ordinary resident, any one condition must fulfill by assessee. So, first condition is assessee proof he is non-resident in 9 previous year out of 10 previous year preceding the relevant current previous year, just immediate preceding the current previous year out of 10 previous year in 9 previous year, assessee prove that he is non-resident. As per the section 6 clause 1, not a single condition is to be fulfilled by assessee in 9 previous year. So, he will be treated as a non-resident out of 10 previous year preceding the relevant current previous year. Second condition, he was in India for a period of 729 days or less in 7 previous year preceding the relevant current previous year, just immediate preceding the current previous year in 7 previous year, the assessee must stay in India for a period of 729 days or less, he will be treated as not ordinary resident. So, any one condition is to be fulfilled, assessee is to be treated as a resident but not ordinary resident. So, these are the beneficial residential status of assessee, a resident, non-resident. If he is resident, whether ordinary resident or not ordinary resident, as per the residential status of assessee, the total income of assessee is to be determined. So, today I am discussing regarding the residential status of assessee, resident, non-resident, resident may be ordinary resident, may be not ordinary resident. So, in the next class, we will discuss regarding the salary, income from the heads of salary. Thank you.